when this car initially was produced, it was known as Zhiguli in the Soviet Union and in most of the Eastern European countries. Now, what we're gonna do is a quick test drive. So let's get into reverse so we can get out of here. And one thing that probably you can notice is that there is no power steering, so everything is manual. Now, what we need to do is get that car into position. No wonder back then women were much stronger, as also they were driving this car. It was not driven only by men. Okay, now let's put the choke back. So this is a manual choke. Basically this one controls the ratio of air and petrol. Now, when you start the car, you always need to have it all the way out, or at least for this car. Now, let's try and get it into first. No, what we're gonna do is turn the ignition on, off I mean, and put into gear, and now have it in first. Okay, that worked, and now we can go. We're up to a temperature, so this time we didn't have to pull the choke all the way out. The mirrors are pretty small though, but I still have good visibility. The front, now we're going with 20 kilometers per hour, which is 16 miles. The feedback of the steering wheel, there is pretty much none. As you can see, I can move it quite a bit, and there is no effect on the wheels. So this is not in any way a racing car.
Equipped with this engine, the Lada is capable of 140 kilometers per hour and 0 to 60 time around 18 seconds.
Most of the Ladas that I see on the road are in a very bad condition, and they're just a pile of rust. But this one, it's been well preserved, as it's been kept in a garage for most of its life. And I'm so impressed of how easy the gears go in and out when they're working.
And here is our Soviet Union masterpiece of engineering, a 67 horsepower 1.3 liter engine.
This car was derived from the Fiat 124, and the more interesting part is that the Fiat 124 was produced and designed in the Pininfarina factory, and back then in the 1970s, when this car originates from, Pininfarina was also building the Ferrari 308 GTB. So obviously the 308 GTB looked better than this car, but still this car, for being half a decade old and still driving, it is a good attestation that they did a good job. There is not that much of things that you can see in here. There is nothing power operated. Even the steering wheel is not powerly assisted. You've got manually operated windows. This is the door latch. You pull that so we can open it. That's how we close it. Pretty thin doors though. There is not much of insulation over here. This is the manual choke here. With that button, you control the fan speed, low, stopped, high speed. Here is the temperature control, whether you want it cold or hot. You've got an ashtray here, and this is how you operate where you want the air to be directed towards. So like this, it blows into the window. If you want it pointed towards you, you go like that. And over here, you can see that we have pretty small windshield wipers. So these are like, yeah, you can see how big these are. And overall, the window is not that big. And on the speedometer, you can see the speed that you're going with. it says up to 160 kilometers per hour, although I would be very frightened if I see the needle all the way up to here. You've got the water temperature and you've got your fuel gauge. So here is going to show you how much fuel you've got. This car has covered 78,350 kilometers. That is around 50,000 miles. Over here on that side, you've got your high beams, you've got your indicators, and you've got your windshield wipers. The rear seat, as it's like a bench, it seems relatively comfortable and spacious enough to fit three adults.
Compared to the Fiat 124, 800 modifications were made, including to rear brakes, disc to drums, suspension for higher ground clearance, carburetor, and some other parts in order to satisfy a wide range of Russian climate conditions, as well as thicker gauge steel. So the Lada 2101 weighed 945 kilograms, the Fiat 90 kilograms less. In short time, Lada became a real hit in the Soviet Union.